Team USA competed in Akita, Japan at the 2001 World Games, bringing home the silver medal, having lost a nail-biter to Team Canada in the final, 17-18. 4 years later, in Duisburg, Germany, Team USA beat Australia 13-11 in the final, bringing home its first World Games gold. The 2009 selection committee chose Greg Connolly as the coach of Team USA for his experience as a player, coach, observer, and ambassador for the sport. A West Coast tryout was held in Los Angeles, California the weekend of February 21st and 22nd, and an East Coast tryout was held in Sarasota, Florida, February 28th to March 1st. Coach Connolly chose a roster of 20 players, 13 of which will head to Kaohsiung for the World Games. This is Team USA 2009. Bart Watson is one of the three returning players from Team USA 2005. Bart played college ultimate with Stanford Bloodthirsty and with Cal UGMO, and won a UPA college championship with Stanford in 2002. Bart is also a longtime veteran of San Francisco's Jam, having recently won the 2008 UPA Club Championships. Bart is a devastating cutter for Jam's offense, and he has the throws to match. Gabe Sanka played college ultimate for Cal UGMO, and he's played club for Valhalla, Furious, and for the last several years, Jam. Gabe has two club titles, one with Furious in 2003 and another last year with Jam. He's a creative thrower for Jam's offense and uses his height and great pivots for his exceptional breakmark throws. John Remicall played his college ultimate in Northfield, Minnesota with Carleton College. Also a Jam veteran, Remicall is coming off a UPA club championship and is a rock of a handler for Jam's defense. His ability to work the disc is second only to his ability to consistently get blocks. Gwen Ambler is another returner to Team USA after being an alternate on the 2005 team. Gwen's illustrious ultimate career has yielded one college title with Stanford and four club titles and a world championship with Fury. Gwen has great throws on offense and plays stifling D. Alicia White started her ultimate career with UC San Diego's Psycho and helped them win a UPA college title as a sophomore in 2002. She has since won three club titles with Fury as well as a world championship. Alicia is one of the best defenders in the game and a tireless cutter for Fury. Cree Howard is the only active college player on Team USA, playing for Cal's Pie Queens. She also plays club for Fury, where this past year she won a club title and a world title. Cree uses her incredible speed as a cutter to run opposing defenses ragged. Bo Kittredge competed with the University of Colorado Mama Bird and won a college title in 2004. Bo played several years with Johnny Bravo, but now plays for the San Francisco Bay Area Revolver. It's safe to say that no player runs faster or jumps higher than Bo. He's been an X factor for every team he's played for and can dominate on both offense and defense. Steven Ruiz also played for Colorado Mama Bird, reaching the 2001 college championship final. Steven is a longtime veteran of Johnny Bravo, also making it to the club finals in 2007. Ruiz anchors Bravo's offense as a handler who uses his throws to punish opposing defenses. Adam Simon is another Mama Bird alumni, winning a college title in 2004. He has since played with Johnny Bravo, but is now playing with Boston's Ironside. Adam is a phenomenal handler defender and isn't afraid to use his huge deep throws after getting the block. Julian Dahl played for Colorado Mama Bird and also won a college title in 2004. He is currently playing for Johnny Bravo. An all-around great athlete, Julian is capable of getting it done on offense and defense, and can be quite an aggressive thrower. Kara Crouch played her ultimate career with Texas Melee, where she won the Callahan Award in 2005. She currently plays club for Showdown, where her spectacular throws help lead the O-line. Deb Cusson is another returner to Team USA from the 2005 squad. Deb played her college years with Carlton Syzygy and has since won two club titles with Seattle Riot. She currently plays for Ozone in Atlanta. Deb is an outstanding thrower whose poise with the disc gives confidence to any offense she plays for. Kathy Dobson played at college for MIT's Smite and now plays for Boston's Brute Squad. Kathy reached the UPA college finals with MIT and her height makes her a dangerous receiver and defender. Jared Inselman played his college ultimate for the University of Pennsylvania Void and 1 year on University of North Carolina Chapel Hill's Dark Side. He currently plays club for Ring of Fire. Jared is a smooth-throwing handler who uses his length to his advantage and seems to break the mark with ease. Dylan Tennell went to college at the University of Georgia, where he played with Joja. He currently plays for Atlanta's Chain Lightning. Dylan is one of the most dominant big men in U.S. Ultimate and is a force to be reckoned with for Chain's offense. Seth Wiggins attended the University of Oregon and played his college ultimate there with Ego. Since then, Seth has played with Portland Rhino, Seattle Sockeye, where he won a UPA club championship in 2007, and most recently, San Francisco Bay Area's Revolver. Seth plays incredible defense and has all the offensive tools one could ask for. Sam CK played his college career for UC Santa Cruz Slugs and now plays for Seattle Sockeye, where he has won an impressive three club titles. Sam is a relentless cutter for the Sockeye O-line with breakaway speed, great leaping ability, and exceptional hands. Kate Foster played for the College of Charleston and currently plays club for backhoe. Kate is probably the fastest woman on Team USA, which makes her one of the fastest women in all of Ultimate. Liz Duffy played her college Ultimate for Amherst College and now plays club for Seattle Riot, where she's won two UPA club championships. Chelsea Putnam played college Ultimate with Oregon Fugue, winning the Callahan Award in 2003. She has since been playing club for Portland Schwa. Chelsea is a phenomenal athlete that plays with incredible passion and regularly puts her team before her body. To get Team USA familiar with one another, four practice weekends were held in various locations in the U.S. These weekends were also used to offer the knowledge and experience of Team USA's athletes in the form of clinics to local players. Their final practice was at the 2009 UPA College Championships in Columbus, Ohio, where Team USA squared off against a college alumni all-star team in front of hundreds of aspiring college players. Despite some nice plays by the college alumni, Team USA won the game 15-3. On June 13th and 14th, Team USA headed to the Jeff Warr Poultry Days Ultimate Classic in Versailles, Ohio. Poultry Days is one of the summer's most competitive co-ed tournaments and a great venue for Team USA to test its mettle in a tournament format. What made Poultry Days 09 special was that Team USA was joined by the World Games teams from Canada, Great Britain, and Chinese Taipei. All four teams were placed in a pool together on the Saturday of the tournament, and that pool's results would be seeded into the Sunday championship bracket. In the Saturday evening showcase game, Team USA squared off against Team Canada. The USA's practice weekends paid off, and their experience playing with one another showed with a 17-9 statement win. The final was a rematch between Team USA and Team Canada, and the Canadians looked stronger and more confident on Sunday, holding Team USA off and going on to a 13-11 win. The biggest test for Team USA came July 3rd to 5th at Potlatch in Redmond, Washington. Potlatch is another summer tournament staple for 2,000-plus Ultimate players and is arguably the most competitive co-ed tournament in the world. On Friday evening in Redmond, Potlatch goers were treated to a showcase game between Team USA and Team Canada. The fans got their money's worth with several lead changes, big plays, and generally close play throughout. Again, Team USA won a showcase game against the Canadians, this time by a score of 15-13. Though the strength of the rest of the field at Potlatch was quite strong, USA and Canada met up again in their second tournament final. Canada came out a bit shaky, but refocused when was able to take half 7-6. Team USA and coach Greg Connolly made some adjustments and absolutely dominated the second half, taking the game running away 13-7. Team USA 2009 now heads to Kaohsiung, Chinese Taipei with 5 months of training, practice, and two tournaments behind them. To support Team USA and follow its quest for World Games gold, go to the UPA website at www.upa.org.